Good evening, friends, fiends, and Night Owl Supremes. Welcome to A Bit Late. Tonight we have a lighthearted and absurd and unseemly, oh, the scandal, fairy tale to read together. That's right, it's The Golden Goose collected by the Brothers Grimm. So it is short, but get comfy, get cozy regardless. Summon your animal familiars, grab a spot of tea, and a ton of blankets. Goose down, maybe? I don't know if that's appropriate or if that's in poor taste. I don't know, whatever you need to be warm or cool. If you need to be cool, probably not down for that. Don't get down with the down if you're warm. Anyway, sorry for that bad joke. I promise the story will not have them. It's just weird and funny and absurd in its own charming way. So without further ado, follow me into this wild story of the Golden Goose, collected again by the Brothers Grimm. There was a man who had three sons, the youngest of whom was called Dunderhead. Oh, poor Dunderhead. And was despised, mocked, and put down on every occasion. And now I feel bad. Great. Sorry, Dunderhead. We're rooting for ya. It happened that the eldest wanted to go into the forest to hew wood. Sure. Like you do, you just gotta wanna do it. Before he went, his mother gave him a beautiful sweet cake and a bottle of wine that he might not suffer from hunger or thirst. Thanks, Mom. When he entered the forest, there he met a little old gray man who bade him good day and said, "Do give me a piece of cake out of your pocket and let me have a draught of your wine. I am so hungry and thirsty." But the prudent youth answered, "If I give you my cake and wine, I shall have none left for myself. Be off with you." And he left the little man standing and went on. Nuh-uh-uh. But when he began to hew down a tree, it was not long before he made a false stroke, and the axe cut him in the arm. That is quite a false stroke, sir. Better put some wine on that. So he had to go home and have it bound up. Nope, Mommy will take care of it. And this was the little gray man's doing. Seems like a stretch. After this, the second son went into the forest and his mother gave him, like the eldest, a cake and a bottle of wine. The little old gray man met him likewise and asked for a piece of cake and a drink of wine. But the second son too said with much reason, "What I give you will be taken away from myself. Be off." And he left the little man standing and went on. Or, if you have extra, you could share and everyone will eat it. Whatever. He only asked for a baby bit. His punishment, however, was not delayed. When he had made a few strokes at the tree, he struck himself in the leg. Youch! So he had to be carried home. By whom? Was he alone? Did he call for help? Fairy tales don't go into this level of detail, but my mind does. Let's say there were some friends in the woods at a neighboring tree, and they all brought him home, because it doesn't say he crawled. He had to be carried. Then Dunderhead said, "Father, do let me go cut wood." The father answered, "Your brothers have hurt themselves doing so. Leave it alone. You do not understand anything about it." But Dunderhead begged so long that at last he said, "Go then. You will get wiser by hurting yourself." "Wow, Dad, you're a real gem. Thanks. Love you too." His mother gave him a cake made with water and baked in the cinders. Ugh. I bet the brothers got milk cake. And with it, a bottle of sour beer. Clearly, he is not the favorite child at all. Wow, Mom and Dad are really nice. When he came to the forest, the little old gray man met him likewise, and greeting him, he said, "Give me a piece of your cake and a drink out of your beer. I am so hungry and thirsty." Dunderhead answered, "I have only cinder cake and sour beer. If that pleases you, we will sit down together and eat." So they sat down, and when Dunderhead pulled out his cinder cake, it was a fine, sweet cake, and the sour beer had become good wine. Well, this man is magical. So they ate and drank, and after that the little man said, "Since you have a good heart and are willing to divide what you have, I will give you good luck. There stands an old tree. Cut it down, and you will find something at its roots." Mysterious. Then the old man took leave of him. Dunderhead went and cut down the tree, and when it fell, there was a goose sitting in its roots. What? that you couldn't see before, with feathers of pure gold.
Whoa.
He lifted her up and, taking her with him, went to an inn. Not back home? I guess screw mom and dad, they gave you water cinder cake. Where he thought he would stay the night. Now the host had three daughters who saw the goose and were curious to know what such a wonderful bird might be. Oh, and each wanted one of its feathers. Of course they did. The eldest thought, I shall soon find an opportunity of pulling out a feather. And when Dunderhead was gone, she seized the goose by the wing, but her finger and hand remained sticking fast to it. Oof. The second came in soon afterward, thinking only how she might get a feather for herself, but she had scarcely touched her sister than she was held fast. Uh-oh. At last the third came in with like intent, and the others screamed out, Keep away, for goodness sake, keep away! But she did not understand why she was to keep away. The others are there, she thought. I might as well be there too. Well, yeah, Big Sis and Sis number two are doing this. I want to belong. Also, I want a feather. They're trying to keep me away from them. But, you know, gotta do what Big Sisters are doing. Anyway, as soon as she had touched her sister, she remained sticking fast to her. So they had to spend the night with the goose. In, like, the roost? Or is the goose in the guy's room and he's gonna come back? I love fairy tales so freaking much. The next morning, Dunderhead took the goose under his arm and set out, without troubling himself about the three girls who were hanging on to it. They were obliged to run after him, now left, now right, just as he was inclined to go. Wow, he really is oblivious, isn't he? But I do love this. It's quite the commotion. In the middle of the fields, the parson met them, and when he saw the procession, he said, For shame, you good-for-nothing girls! Why are you running across the fields after this young man? Is that seemly? Oh, wow. Judge much, old man? At the same time, he seized the youngest by the hand in order to pull her away. But as soon as he touched her, he was likewise stuck fast and was obliged to run behind. Wow, so unseemly, sir. Before long, the sexton came by and saw his master, the parson, running on foot behind three girls. How unseemly. He was astonished at this and called out, Hi, your reverence, whither away so quickly? Do not forget that we have a christening today. And running after him, he took him by the sleeve, but was also held fast. Yes, so unseemly. The unseemliness is growing and I'm about it. While the five were trotting thus, one behind the other, and we don't know where they're headed, which is amazing, two laborers came with their hoes from the fields. The parson called out to them and begged them that they would set him and the sexton free. Who cares about the little girls, I guess, that you were so worried about before? Whatever. But they had scarcely touched the sexton when they were held fast. And now there were seven of them running behind Dunderhead and the goose. Yes. Soon afterward, he came to a city where a king ruled who had a daughter who was so serious that no one could make her laugh. So he had put forth the decree that whosoever should make her laugh should marry her. That seems very frivolous and in exact opposition to her nature, but okay. When Dunderhead heard this, he went with his goose and all her train before the king's daughter. Didn't have a plan before he heard that, though. Love it. As soon as the princess saw the seven people running on and on, one behind the other, she began to laugh very loudly as if she would never leave off. Thereupon, Dunderhead asked to have her for his wife, and the wedding was celebrated. After the king's death, Dunderhead inherited the kingdom and lived a long time contentedly with his wife. And, presumably, the goose and the seven other hangers-on? Anyway, the end to our absurd fairy tale. I do hope you enjoyed it and it add a little bit of lightheartedness and cheer to your evening or to your day if you're working on something cool. Hope it's awesome. Hope this helped you work a little more or get into your groove a little easier. I don't know. Hope you're doing fantastically. And if you had a heavy heart or were very serious when we started this tale, hopefully the absurdity of it made you laugh or brought you some cheer or made you smile a bit. But now, off to sleep and dream what you will, or stay a while and enjoy another tale. Whichever you choose, I'll speak to you again. And until then, stay spooky and silly, my friends. Good night.